Hello and welcome to Standard Costing Part 3, or the Total Overhead Variance, aka the Controllable Overhead Cost Variance. My disclaimer and copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College and the South Orange County Community College District. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2020 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. Presentations from time to time use information from third parties. Third party information, the third party information is the property of those respective copyright holders, and the author does not make any claim to the third party information. So what we're going to be looking at is overhead, but we're going to be looking at it overhead in three separate videos. And I'm doing this on purpose just to do one video. It might be over an hour. So let's go ahead and take a look at this first overhead variance. So when we're looking at overhead variances, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to compute what is the total overhead variance. And that's going to be the focus of this video. What we will then do is look at, and we know that overhead is made up of two parts, fixed overhead or fixed factory overhead and variable factory overhead. What we're gonna do on the second video, or video number 4 in this series, is we're gonna look at variable overhead and their related spending and efficiency variances. And then we're gonna look at the total fixed overhead variance, which will be in the fifth video. And we'll go through and look at those fixed overhead variances. One of the things though that you're going to notice as we kind of go through and do this, and this is why I broke it up into several different parts, is on the other videos I've shared with you with direct materials and direct labor, we like to have a nice way of checking our work. I add up my rate variance or my rate variance plus my efficiency variance, and I get my total direct labor variance. I add up my price variance and my quantity variance, and I get my total direct materials variance. But here we're gonna be doing something a little bit different, because we're not going to add up all of the variable and all the fixed overhead variances together. And the reason being is when we get here, what we're gonna see is part of this fixed overhead variance is more internal, meaning it's more of what we call a volume variance. So when we get there, we'll see that, but that's kind of the reason why we're gonna be stepping it up and kind of doing it like this. So factory overhead is made up of two components, variable and fixed. And again, the first thing we wanna do when we have a question like this is to look at the actual overhead versus the budgeted overhead to kind of see where we are. And they will sometimes call this difference is called the overhead controllable variance. So again, why are we doing this? We are looking for ways to go through and to see if during production, if we have to make changes. And so this is really why we're looking at direct labor, direct materials, variable overhead, and fixed overhead. So we're now kind of on this part right here in terms of standard costs. And so the first thing we will do is we're going to compute the overall overhead, factory overhead variance. And this is going to be the difference between our actual overhead incurred, fixed plus variable overheads, less the budgeted overhead at the percent level that we were operated at during the period. And this is really important. So generally when you receive these types of questions, it will say to you like, oh, we were operating at a certain percentage. So for this problem right here, for FSI, they were operating at around 80% efficiency. So it's really important to kind of take note of that. So let's take a look at our ever-evolving example. So FSI had the following actual fixed and variable overhead costs during the month of October. And if you look back at the second video, you will see that there was 14,000 hours of direct labor that were used to produce 30,000 shirts or units. So FSI had variable overhead of 392,000. It had fixed overhead of 210,000 for a total overhead of 602,000. Now, to go through over here and produce one shirt, as we've seen in the prior examples, They budgeted 0.5 labor hours. So for our example here, they made 30,000 shirts. So the standard amount of hours to go through and do this would be 15,000. And that's kind of where these numbers here are coming from. So when you see this production in units, the direct labor hours is 0.5 of that. Again, these are the production capacity. These are my standard costs. Now over here, it tells us that the overhead rates are based on a production capacity level of 90%. So this is going to come into play a little bit later when we go and take a look at that fixed factory overhead. But as of right now, here are the budgeted overhead rates. So we've got our units of production, production in units, our direct labor hours, budgeted variable factory overhead, and we have our budgeted fixed factory overhead. So because I produced 30,000 shirts, in order to determine what should be the total standard cost or what should I have paid for overhead, it is going to be the sum of these two values right here, or 450,000, because remember, I'm right here at 30,000 units of production, plus 185,625. So here's what I actually paid. I actually paid 602,000. And then over here, the budgeted amount basically is we're operating at that capacity. So right over here, since I'm producing 30,000 units, I want to use this capacity level. So this is going to be 450,000 plus 185,625. So my total budgeted overhead is 635,625. So taking a step back for a moment, if I actually spent 602,000, but my budgeted amount was 635,000, is that going to be favorable or unfavorable? Well, the answer to that is it's going to be favorable because I spent less than I had gone through and budgeted. So this is the very first step, and our overall variance is 33,625 favorable on an overall basis because we have spent less than what we actually went through and budgeted. So again, key points here, we take our total overhead and we're going to go through and we're going to compare that to the overhead at our relevant production capacity, which in right over here is 635,625. So I want to thank you for watching today. If you have any comments or questions, please send them to 1812cpa@gmail.com. Have a great one and a pleasant tomorrow. Thank you.